too brave enough to step down to the second step, so I'll stick down here. On July the 15th, 1776, 72 patriots, led by Benjamin Franklin, issued Pennsylvania's first ever constitution. One sentence from that document read, quote, that all power inherent in and consequently derived from the people. Therefore, all officers of government are their trustees and servants, and at all times accountable to them. Our founders clearly realized that all power stems from the people, from us, and all officers of government are not masters, but servants. Yeah. Most importantly, the Constitution was written under the principle of positive grant. What positive grant means is that the government can only exercise the powers which are specifically granted to it and nothing more. The Constitution is not the authority over our lives. It is simply the law meant to constrain the actions of government. However, over time, the federal government has slowly and steadily taken more and more power from the people, from our local and state governments. Look at the bailout of the banks, insurance companies, car companies, and investment firms. There is nothing in the Constitution that gives Congress or the Federal Reserve the power to do any of this. So what to do? What can be done against this government? What are the best actions that people who believe in the rule of law, who believe in freedom, do? What I favor is a strong shift back to the America that our founding fathers had in mind. If we can shift these powers back closer to the people, from the federal government's to the state and local governments, the better off we will all be. The more local each issue becomes, the more voice, the more power each individual has, and the happier we will all be. The 4th of July for the Patriots of 76 was only the start of a long march towards freedom and liberty. It is in their spirits that we, from our families first, from our local communities second, and from the state of Pennsylvania third, must rise up and defend freedom from a government that disrespects the rule of law and the boundaries of its constitutional powers. We can start and we can win this revolution of our lifetimes today if only a few good women, if only a few good men are brave enough to place their bodies and minds between our families and the establishment, this government that acts as if the Constitution were just a piece of paper. As for myself, I have decided to run for political office for United States Congress, even though I have no prior political experience. I have a very strong message to share and a plan to implement accountability and transparency to return the money power from the government to the people where it belongs. And to fiercely defend individual liberty and the rule of law. I have decided to also run as a private citizen, unaffiliated with any political parties. I do not desire to represent either the Democrat or Republican parties. I desire to represent us, the people of this district, whom I am willing to serve. I believe that the current Republican and Democrat representatives have been leading our country down the path of both moral and economic ruin. Our two-headed but one-party system and political scene is not the sharp divide the politicians and the media want us all to believe. The true difference between the Democrat and Republican politicians in power is no greater than the choice between Coke and Pepsi in a supermarket. To me, the real choice is simple. Today, we either choose liberty or we choose tyranny. We either choose prosperity for those who will earn it, or poverty will be the result for us all. Today, we decide between a republic of laws or mob rule by the gang in Washington. Today, we decide if we are women and men of principle, or if we will let politics as usual and the lesser of two evils continue to ruin our lives and the lives of our children. What I would like more than anything is to join with a team of candidates, I don't care what party they're from, who have the spirit of 76, who share the same principles and belief in individual liberty as I do, and are focused on saving our great country from those who threaten it, the true enemies domestic. America was conceived in liberty, and I will not let our republic fall to the cowards who defile it without a bitter fight. These cowards will do whatever they can to remain in power, to control us by debasing our money and throwing away our liberties as if they were garbage. Our republic was not established by cowards, and cowards have no chance of preserving it. Their favorite strategy is divide and conquer. They will prey upon our differences in race, skin color, gender, and religious creeds in attempts to turn us upon ourselves. They will try to set our citizens senior against our country's young people. They will try to set the rich, the poor, and the middle class at each other's throats, for this is the only way they can stay in power. We must act together. We must realize that we are all Americans. We are all on the same side. Yeah. In closing, at the Continental Congress, as our founders signed the Declaration of Independence, Ben Franklin said, "We must indeed all hang together, or most assuredly, we will all hang separately." Thank you. I'd like to introduce our next speaker. Next we have...